Hi, I'm Juliet, and today I'm following on from the last video with issues you need to look out for when compiling a paperback from Scrivener 3 for Windows. There will again be a lot of jumping back and forth in this video, and I won't be touching on subjects that I've already discussed in previous videos unless I have something further to add. So, I spent some time converting the titles I wanted in the TOC and the main text to styles. I did have a problem with page endings not lining up, and it took me quite a while to work out what was happening. Sometimes this can be because of the title size not matching with the line spacing, and that was what I tried first. It was better, but not perfect. And then I noticed it. Most of the text you bring across from Scrivener comes up just as normal text. But where I'd created or used standard specific styles in Scrivener 3, those had actually come across as styles in Microsoft Word. If you watched the ebook video, you probably know what I'm going to say now. The line spacing on those styles didn't match the document. So if you create a style, you probably don't want to change it in Scrivener, because that might screw up the ebook. But you do want to change it in Microsoft Word. Those first paragraphs where I created an indent without forced justification for the ebook, in the paperback, unfortunately, come across as left aligned. I have mentioned this before, but whereas images get extra automatic spacing around them in ebooks, they don't in paperbacks. So you will have to adjust that, and probably the image size. Oh, and one thing about the TOC. If you don't want your TOC titles in capitals, change the style to forced capitals in the font options, but type the titles in upper and lower case. I have made a lot of other changes to this book, but those are only style and preference related. I might discover other issues as I refine it. If I do, I'll be sure to make a video about those. Thanks for watching, and if you've subscribed, I'll see you again next time.